Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone, this is Ashima, and in this video we'll be talking about daily current affairs or daily news events. Now, the discussion on this video is going to be more concerned with the daily news events in detail discussion, right? So that it is helpful for all the examination aspirants and not confined to a particular examination aspirant category, right? So here, what we are going to talk about is a news event. But for those who want to practice the questions as well, for them, we have an everyday quiz, a live quiz that happens on Entry app. And that happens in any language you opt to do that in. So you can choose the language you want to appear in, and then you can attempt the quiz. All you need to do is download the app from Google Play Store, right? And then everything is going to be sorted for you. And along with, if you download it right now, you also get a 7 days free trial on all the courses of Entry app. So all you need to do is download, do the registration process, and then 7 days free trial begins for any course you want, either banking or CET, or you can say SSC examinations, whichever examination you're preparing for. Now, with this, we'll be beginning our discussion. So don't forget to like the video and share the video to all those people you can think of while talking about the news events. Right now, the first news event is Council of Palm Oil Producing Countries. Now, this council has recently made some major decision, which is why it is in news as of now. So, what is the decision about? First of all the top palm oil producers of the time, for the first time, are looking for opportunities to run an advocacy campaign in Europe. That is, they are quite not in favor of Europe because of certain decisions which have been taken by European Union. So to show their protest against it, they are looking for opportunities where they can run a campaign against Europe, as we can say, on a whole. Now, what are the countries that are there under this campaign? The leaders, or you can say the primary, or you can say the front holders of this, is Indonesia and Malaysia, which are approximately 85% producers of palm oil in the world. Now, what the issue is regarding it, why European Union is being criticized in all of this, it is because according to Union, they want to ramp up legislations on deforestation as a part of European Green Deal. So European Union is trying to avoid deforestation as a whole. That is, they want some green development to take place, whereas the producers of palm oil in Malaysia, they clear a lot of area of biodiversity in Southeast Asia to exploit, and along with that, they exploit the migrant workers for the purpose of producing palm oil. So that deforestation is the one which European Union is against, and for that purpose they are looking that there's a possibility that they could restrict the use of palm oil fuel and food. In fuel and fuel, in both of those, palm oil can be restricted by European Union, as it is being seen as per the European Green Deal. So for that purpose, this council is completely against European Union for the matter. If we have a look at the council, Malaysia and Indonesia account for 85% of the global palm oil output, and India and China are the biggest buyers of palm oil as of now from these union. Right now, if we talk about the council as a whole, that what is the council about? So Council of Palm Oil Producing Countries is an intergovernmental organization which was established in 2015, and it was founded by Indonesia and Malaysia, the primary producers of palm oil in the world. European Green Deal is the one in which it's looking for policy initiatives to make European Union climate neutral by 2050, for which it is taking every measure possible. Right, next which we have is Star Streak Air Defense System. Now, for this defense system, India has signed an agreement with France on the matter. Right, so India and France have signed an agreement for this Star Streak defense missile system. Now, what is this Star Streak and what are the properties of it? First of all, it is a short-range surface-to-air missile. Short-range surface-to-air missile which travels at Mach 3 speed, right? And then What does Mach 3 mean? It means that it travels at the 3 times the speed of sound. That is, what is the speed of sound? 3 times of that is the speed of star streak. Now, the minimum range of the system is 0.3 kilometers, as you can see over here, and the maximum range is 7 kilometers. And there are other variants of this system, that is star streak system variant 2, that has more than 7 kilometer range. And then other variant might have more. So it is dependent upon the variant, but the minimum, if we talk about, in the primary one is 7 kilometers maximum and minimum is 0.3 kilometers. Right. As of now, it is installed. It is currently the fastest short-range surface-to-air missile in the world. Right. And it is made of 3 laser-guided darts. Right. Now, what are the benefits of it? First of all, it makes difficult for pilots to evade because of the speed that it has. Then it cannot be jammed with infrared countermeasures, and then it cannot be suppressed with anti-radar missiles. So there are a lot of benefits of it, although there are some you can say disadvantages as well. That is, it does not have a proximity fuse. That is, when it comes close, it will burst. That is the you can say the disadvantage that this facility is not there, that is proximity fuse is not present. That is, when it goes near, it will fuse, that is proximity fuse. Right. Now, then we have a Davos Agenda Summit 2021. Now, what is in this summit? It is organized by World Economic Forum, and in this summit, Great Reset Initiative is set to be launched by the World Economic Forum. So, what was the theme of the Davos Summit? That is, stakeholders for cohesive and sustainable world. Now, this summit is quite important also from the perspective that India and China both will be participating in this. That is, Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi will be present, and the Chinese President Xi Jinping. He is also going to be present in this Davos Agenda Summit as of now, as per the recent updates are. Right. Now, there are certain decisions that have to be taken as of now. That is, America First policy of United States of America. It has created a huge breakdown, like leaving Paris Agreement for the matter. So it has undermined a lot of global efforts. So there can be certain decisions or focus areas on America First policy. Then the tensions of Iran. Especially the tussle between US and Iran. So for that purpose, then Russia's annexation of Crimea has strained the tensions between US and Russia for more than since Cold War. So for that also. Now here we have said about something called Great Reset Initiative. So what is this initiative that they are going to launch? So it is basically, World Economic Forum has brought up a new twin summit format in the Davos meeting. So one of the meeting is the usual Davos Agenda Summit, and the other is going to be the new Reset Initiative, right? And Great Reset Initiative, what is it going to bring? It is going to bring world leaders and focus on managing the direct consequences of COVID-19 crisis. That is, what the direct hits have happened due to COVID-19, they are going to be studied under the Great Reset Initiative. Right? As of now, it is going to be started to recover the global economy from the COVID-19 hit that most of the countries have witnessed, for the matter. Then Global Firepower Index 2021 was released recently. So who prepared the index and what is the index about? So this index basically ranks the countries based on their potential military strength. That is, what military strength is there in the countries. According to the strength they have, ranking is done. Right? Now, how many total countries are ranked? About 138 countries on a total are ranked. And out of them, India was ranked 4th. Again, top was United States of America, followed by Russia and China. So top 3 were USA, Russia and China. So United States has about 904 attack helicopters, making it the top one. Then after United States, we have Russia with 189 fighter aircraft and other, you can say, other defense equipments. Then China, about 1200 combat aircraft, and India has about 542 combat aircraft, 17 submarines for the matter, that need to be known for us. Then after the top 3 countries, we have Japan, which was ranked 5th, and South Korea, which was ranked 6th in the ranking. Right? Now, with South Korea, we have North Korea also. So now, what was the rank of North Korea? It was 28. So North Korea was 28 and South Korea was 6th ranked country over here, right? Then our neighboring country also we have to be known about. So if we talk about Pakistan, it was the 10th most powerful country in terms of defense equipments. Then we have India Innovation Index. Now, India Innovation Index is released by NITI Aayog, right? And it checks on the states, or it's a healthy competition between states as to how open the states are to taking innovative measures, right? So, bringing in innovation, how open are the states for that? That is what this Innovation Index measures. So, the first edition of India Innovation Index was launched in 2019, and this is the second edition which is being launched in 2021, right? So, here we can infer that it is a biennial report. Now, it is developed on lines of Global Innovation Index, just like we have Global Innovation Index. Similarly, we have India Innovation Index. And what is the ranking? Karnataka has retained its spot as the first position holder. Now, in India Innovation Index, we have three categories. One is the major states, one is hilly states or small states, and one is union territories, right? So, northeast and hilly, major and union territory or small states, these are the three categories. So, in major, we have Karnataka, which has topped, and second is Maharashtra, third is Tamil Nadu. Then we have the ranking for hilly states or northeastern states, that is Himachal at the top, Uttarakhand and Manipur following it at second and third position. Then we have union territories. In union territories or small states, we have Delhi, which has topped, and Chandigarh, which has ranked in the second position. Right? Then a few one-liners. Bhavna Kant is soon to become the first woman fighter pilot to take part in Republic Day Parade. So she was among the first batch which was inducted in Air Force for women. So first women batch which was inducted by Air Force. In that batch, she was a part of it, or she was the, one of the members, which were the other two. There were three overall. So one was Bhavna Kant, other was Avni Chaturvedi, and the third one was Mohana Singh. Right, so these are the three top three women, or first three women which we can say who were inducted in Indian Air Force. Now, out of them, Bhavna Kant is going to become the first women fighter pilot to take part in Republic Day Parade. Now, she was also the first female fighter pilot of India to qualify for undertaking combat missions. That was in 2019. In 2016, she was inducted. In 2019, she was the first woman to take up or to be qualified for undertaking combat missions, right? For that, in 2020, she had received Nari Shakti Puraskar. Nari Shakti Puraskar was given to her in 2020 for the same purpose, that is, in 2019, she was qualified for combat. Right. Then India Mountaineering Foundation has recently approved a three-member team of mountaineers led by Arjun Vajpayee for winter climbing expedition to Mount Trishul. For Mount Trishul, approval has been given as of now. Now, over here, what is so new is, first of all, India does not allow mountaineering in winter season. Only pre-monsoon and post-monsoon periods are allowed for mountaineering by Government of India. It is for the first time ever that Government of India has approved for a winter climbing. Then we have Mount Trishul. It is a part of the three Himalayan peaks which form a trident, as we can say. So the three names are Trishul 1, Trishul 2 and Trishul 3. And Mount Trishul is at the massif. Massif is running from north to south. Right. Then we have other news event, which is Government of India has recently announced birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose to be celebrated as a Parakram Divas. Now, Parakram means courage. So his birth anniversary is going to be celebrated as Courage Day or Parakram Divas. And when was he born, on which we are going to celebrate? That is 23rd of January. So every year from now on, from 2021, every 23rd January is going to be celebrated as Parakram Parakram Divas on birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Now, as of 2021, central government and Bengal government are going to begin the celebrations of 125th birth anniversary, because this year it is 125th birth anniversary of Subhash Chandra Bose. Right now, with this coming in news, you need to know certain accomplishments of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. For the matter, he was an Indian novelist. He was born in Cuttack. Then he joined Indian National Congress in 1921. He started a newspaper by the name Swaraj. So his newspaper was by the name Swaraj. So that is important. Then his book, The Indian Struggle, is important. The Indian Struggle was the book which was written by him, and that is also equally important. Then the term Jai Hind was coined by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. That is also important. So these are the three important timelines for his accomplishments, for the matter. Right now, with this, we'll be winding up the news event segment. Thank you so much. It has been wonderful interacting with all of you. We'll see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye. Take care and have a wonderful day ahead.